Just recently, I had a speaking engagement at one of the most beautiful places in Switzerland, the Beatenberg Bible School. Talk about deja vu. This was the same place that I visited almost 10 years ago and sat at this very grand piano and played the great song, Majesty, as I overlooked the Swiss Alps panorama. What a great time of worship. I never would have thought in my wildest dreams that someday I would be back in this very school, in this very classroom, next to the very piano, speaking as a missionary to over 60 young people on the topic of missions in Switzerland. I think you're going to love this story. Take a deep breath in, because you're going to see once again the profound fingerprint of the Creator. Thanks for tuning in. I left my home in Jestetten, Germany, and headed south, deep into the Swiss Alps, arriving in Interlaken. I hopped aboard a Mercedes-Benz bus. Who else in the world uses Mercedes-Benz buses for public transportation but the Swiss? And we headed up 20 minutes to a small village nestled quaintly overlooking the freshly snow-capped majestic Alps, specifically the Berner Oberland region, which is the home of the great-renowned Beatenberg Bible School. What a very special place. But not only because of its location, biblical foundation, amazing teaching, history, it was also used as the meeting point for three important guys over 70 years ago, Billy Graham, Dawson Trotman, and Bob Evans. These three men were so burdened for lost Europe and knew they had to do something about it. One of them, by the name of Bob Evans, decided to take the baton and run with it and start what we know as today, Greater Europe Mission. Isn't that fascinating? Every time I remember that story, I'm humbled and grateful to God to serve as a GEM missionary in Switzerland. All I can say is, it's all grace. Check out GEM's 70th anniversary vlog when you get time. So the pre-story is almost 10 years ago, I was visiting this Bible school on this European tour. On that trip, I met some amazing people, learned about Swiss culture, specifically pastors telling me that less than 4% of 8 million people are committed Jesus followers. That was a massive shock. It was incredibly hard to believe that Switzerland had fallen that deeply into humanistic thought, especially since it had a major role in the promotion of the Protestant Reformation 500 years ago. I now look back and see God, who was obviously busy at work, cultivating and planting a seed and calling in my heart. As you know, the seed has grown into a wonderful ministry of serving a number of local churches, discipleship, and regular gospel proclamation. To God be the glory. Thank you, partners, for making this all possible. So, how did it come about me speaking at the school, you ask? I was playing the piano for a worship service in Zurich last year, and afterwards a young man came up to me and started to ask questions about my ministry. He then asked, "Can I share your name with the school that I'm attending in Beatenberg? Because every 2 weeks we have missionaries come and share for 45 minutes. Then we write a 300-word essay on their talk." I told him, "Yes, of course, I would be thrilled to come." So the Bible School administration emailed me to set up the date, time, and details. And so for the next 2 months, I started to prepare for this challenging presentation in German. The school had very specific requirements that the missionary needed to speak on. By the grace of God, I completed it in English, contacted my very good friends, Dominic and Chris, who did a superb job helping me with the complicated German, and off I went. So I arrived at the school, checked in, went to my room, and once again was blown away as to the majestic panorama just outside my window. I mean, really, just look at that. How in the world do Bible students get any work done here with the beauty and the endless opportunities to hike, snowboard, and just chill out? On the day of speaking, I set up my information table, laptop, Swiss flag, and other props. The young people arrived. Each of them had a laptop with them for meticulous note-taking, so for sure the educational pressure was on me. In my presentation, using the German language, I covered the points they wanted me to address. Personal info, who is Jem, cultural differences, how important is intentional prayer, how did the call of God happen, what do I specifically do for the churches I serve, how do I use the two-minute gospel in evangelism, my suggestions to future missionaries, why do I have a YouTube channel, and how important gratitude and thankfulness is to ministry partners. I cracked a couple jokes, I did what some Americans do and took a selfie, which I think they enjoyed. At the end, we had time for Q&A, and three of them had the courage to ask excellent questions. Afterwards, some of us had lunch together. We then proceeded out onto the balcony, where two young ladies talked about their takeaway from the lecture.
Los geht's.
Wir finden oft so viele Worte für alles Mögliche, aber selten für das Wesentliche. Und das zu sehen, wie jemand in zwei Minuten das Evangelium rüberbringt, sodass es aufrüttelt, dass es Leute zum Nachdenken bringt, das ist wirklich inspirierend. Auch wenn es oft gar nicht Frucht trägt, die wir sehen. Ich möchte da lernen, einfach dran zu bleiben und wirklich wieder Worte und Zeit fürs Evangelium zu finden.
Wir hatten heute einen Vortrag von Kevin. Und was mich sehr angesprochen hat, ist, dass er gesagt hat, dass der Hauptpunkt seines Dienstes das Gebet ist. Und das möchte ich für meinen späteren Dienst und auch jetzt dann noch schon mitnehmen.
So as wonderful as that day was with the great students, there really is something greater I need to tell you. I arrived one day early and went to the cable car station. My specific car was loaded with supplies for the restaurant at the top called Niederhorn. At the middle station, Marcus, a snowboard teacher, and his student, 12-year-old Daniela, squeezed in. I used my very limited Swiss-German accent to start the conversation. They laughed and off we went into a discussion about his visit to the USA, Swiss culture, masks, etc. Before we arrived at the top, I said, Marcus, so this beautiful area we are in, where did it come from? A creator or God or what do you think? He told me about his beliefs in a higher power, a non-personal energy, and that all the religions of the world are basically the same. I explained briefly God's love for them both, that it is seen in the life and death of Jesus Christ, and asked them to please think about what we talked about, because it was not a coincidence that we met. The cable car stopped, they got out and headed to the snow for her snowboarding lesson. He gave me permission to use the drone overhead. Here they are doing the twist. Friends, what can I say about intentionally praying for opportunities like this? God is faithful. He hears our prayers, and sometimes He opens doors like this. I ask you, what are you praying about these days? Are you asking Him to get you prepared to share the gospel? Are you genuinely asking Him to open doors? Please pray those exciting prayers and watch what happens. As it says in Luke 14, now is the time to compel people towards the gospel. So thank you so very much, everybody, for watching, tuning in to this interesting vlog about Beatenberg Bible School. I'm back here in Zurich, away from the mountains, and I just ask, will you please continue to pray intentionally for the gospel outreach here in Switzerland by the pastors, by the missionaries, by Christian brothers and sisters, that the gospel would keep going out and out and out, and that there would be much fruit. Thank you so very much for praying. If you have any questions, comments, leave them down below. If you want to see something about Switzerland, about ministry life, or personally, let me know. Okay, see you, bye. And one last quick important announcement. Only by the grace of God has He given me ministry partners in the wonderful state of Hawaii. The Makakilo Bible Church has invited me to come and speak at their missions conference in March. It's going to be a wonderful busy time and then a vacation to follow. You for sure will hear all about the conference. I will give you updates and you will see some very non-Swiss drone shots. I'm very grateful for your prayer support. The schedule is packed with speaking, teaching, cooking, participating in worship at the piano, and just the overall boasting on God. That's our theme verse, Psalm 96:3. Declare His glory among the nations, His marvelous deeds among all peoples. God has been so great over these last 7 years here in Europe. Please pray for health and travels, teaching, and much fruit in sharing the gospel. Thank you so much for praying. See you next time.